Jacob, my servant.
Uh-huh.
O Jacob, my servant.
Right.
And Israel, whom I have chosen.
The Most High God only chosen the people of Israel. The so-called Negroes, Hispanics, Native Americans.
Tu és quem quiser ter a pita escravo, pode se chover no mesmo. Por qual peplo sul a terra? Pode se chover no, por não meter no pior a sua tornação sul a terra. Dile por não quebrar a lua por dia. Sabe por que está pondo a pele no coça? Sabe por que está tudo mise essa passe sul a terra, man? Pode fazer já chover tu lês sul a terra. E te chover muda isso quem o, black man quem o. Jamais qu'il y a des mon poil yo même. Dire pour nous lève pour que belle la loi bonché.
Give me Romans chapter. Give me actually give me Romans 15 and 16.
The book of Romans chapter 15 verse 16.
Because the Most High ordained us to come out here and tell you why you're in a situation, man. Why you're in a situation, man? You're either gonna keep the commandments now, or the Most High gonna put you to death later.
That's right.
You either gotta choose, man. You're gonna keep God's commandments now, or you're going to be put to death later, man. Give me that scripture.
This is the book of Romans, chapter 15, verse 16.
Bring it out!
Leviticus 20 and 13 on them.
Hey,
read that, man. I'm waiting to come back.
That I should be the minister.
That we should be the what?
The minister.
The what?
The minister.
The Most High called us the ministers. That we should be called ministers, read.
Of Amashiach Yahawashah.
Of Amashiach Yahawashah, who is a black man. Christ is a black man according to the Bible.
That's right!
Who the world called Jesus Christ, he is a black man according to the Bible.
Right!
If you see a so-called white man come from the sky, just know he about to put your ass in slavery.
That's right!
To the Gentiles!
To
the Gentiles!
Because when our people not keeping God's commandments, they're like Gentiles, man. You acting just like Donald Trump when you're not keeping God's commandments, man. A lot of people hate him, but they're acting just like him when they're not keeping God's commandments. Give me Romans 10 and 14. What's going on, brother? What's going on, brother, man? Let me talk to you for a minute. 2 minutes, brother. How bad she is over there, man. You got to push that over there. You got to keep God's commandments, man. Our people are insane.
That's right.
Read that for me.
This is the book of Romans, chapter 10, verse 14.
And Jeremiah 8 and 3. Read.
How then shall they call on him?
Yo, what's going on, sis? Why don't you give us 2 minutes to find out why we are here, man?
I'm not working.
2 minutes? You can't go on lunch or break? But if I was 6'3 with abs and I look like Drake, you are right over here trying to kiss my feet.
That's right!
You can't be lying. If I look like Drake, you are out there backflip over here.
Right.
Read that for me.
How then shall they call on him?
How can they call to the Most High, read?
In whom they have not believed.
Because they are people who don't believe in God, man. The so-called black Americans, Haitians, and West Indians, they don't believe in a God, man. Because if they did, they wouldn't be acting like animals out here, man.
Right.
Read.
And how shall they believe in him,
right,
of whom they have not heard,
right?
And how shall they hear without a preacher?
How can they what?
Hear without a preacher.
How can they what?
Hear without a preacher.
How can our people learn about the Most High God without a preacher, man? Without us coming out here in these last days, man. First, Second Peter, actually, give me that Jeremiah 8 and 3. And then Second Peter 2 and 12. Because when our people not keeping God's commandments, you're like priests, man. You're like raccoons and possums. We're not keeping God's commandments. Read that for me, Jeremiah 8 verse 3.
This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 8, verse 3. And death shall be chosen.
Shall what?
And death shall be chosen.
Most High God said death shall be chosen, brother. Now, brother, why don't you come here and give me a minute, man? We had to tell you who you are according to the Bible. So why is here? Okay, drop who came along, boy. So I'm not saying Bible no figure, but that to you, let boy, because we've been lying, man.
That's why we.
You know, put a cable along, boy. So my name, Bible no figure, tell our master see who yeah.
That's why we.
Read that for me.
And death shall be chosen rather than life.
Most High God said our people gonna choose death rather than life, man. That's serious, man. Most High God said death gonna be chosen rather than life, man.
Right.
Life is keeping the Most High's law, statute, commandments. Give me that 2 Peter 2 and 12 now. And then Proverbs 8 and 32.
I'll be able to put 3 more scriptures. Next
verse. 2 Peter 2 and 12.
This is the book of 2 Peter, chapter 2, verse 12.
Right.
But these, as natural brute, the beasts.
Hold up. What's going on, brother? Your brother, man. Big Bill. Read that for me. Read it again.
But these, as natural brute beasts.
Most I say, these are natural brute beasts, man. Read.
Made to be taken and destroyed.
Made to be what?
taken and destroyed.
When you're not keeping God's commandments, you're like brute beasts ready for the slaughter, man. They're just ready for them angels to knock your head off, man.
That's right.
To choke, to take your pants off and choke you with those pants you're sagging in. Yo, brother, why don't you give us 2 minutes, man? We out here for you. What you is, Haitian? You Jamaican? Do you love God? You don't love God, because if you love God, you won't have your beard. You won't have your beard, man. Our people be homosexuals, man. How you threatening the prophets, man? That's gay. Read that for me.
Right. But these as natural brute beasts,
right,
made to be taken,
right,
and destroyed,
right,
speak evil of things that they understand not.
They speak things they understand not. Our people say they love God, but they stick a middle finger at their brother. You try to sodomize your brother? Our people say they love the Most High God, but they smoke you weed. Our people say they love the Most High God, and they're not obedient to their husbands, man. A lot of these women are going to catch a heart attack in these last days when they find out their man is their CEO, President, King, and Emperor rule over them.
Right. Yeah.
They're going to catch a heart attack when Christ tell them that, right, to their face. Give me that next scripture I told you to call out. Next scripture. Our people got to wake up and keep Proverbs 8:32. What's going on, sis? Proverbs 8:32. Proverbs 8, verse 32. Read that for me. Proverbs 8, verse 32. My shit, y'all wish I made a statement in the scriptures, man. Proverbs 8, verse 32.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 8, verse 32.
You don't give me Philippians 1:17. That'll be my last scripture.
Now, therefore, hearken unto me.
We got to hearken to the Most High God in Christ, man. Read.
O ye children,
man. Because you're the children of the Most High God. You're the people God chosen, man. Let's see what he said about his children. Hold that scripture. 1 John chapter 3, verse 7. 1 John chapter 3, verse 7 to 8, and then you're going to go back to Proverbs. Once I say, hearken unto me, O children, because we're the children of the living power, man. Where the people God destroyed the firstborns of the Egyptians for, man? They crushed the Babylonians, man. The Moabites, the Ishmaelites, the Amalekites, man, when they came against our people in the wilderness. He's that same God who always been with our people, man. Read.
This is the book of 1 John, chapter 3, verse 7.
Right.
Little children,
right,
let no man deceive you.
Don't let none of these pastors, bishops, and deacons deceive you. Read.
He that doeth righteousness,
what is righteousness? The law, statute, commandments of the Heavenly Father, man. What's going on, brother?
I'm a Messianic Jew.
Yo, brother, we a Messianic Jew too. We believe in the Savior.
Right.
But I don't want you to run away. You gotta talk with us, brother.
So why do y'all call yourself Hebrew Israelites?
Come talk with us.
So why y'all call yourself Hebrew Israelites?
Because according to the Bible, we are the Jews. We're the Hebrews.
You know what Hebrew is?
Of course I know Hebrew. The
black.
Descendant of Eber.
Black.
That's what it means,
black.
That's how Kadar means Hebrew, brother.
What is Hebrew then? Hebrew.
Every brother is descendant of Eber in Genesis, brother. That's why we're Hebrews. It's like Abraham was called a Hebrew. Now let me ask you a question. You know you're Hebrew, right?
Of course I'm a Hebrew.
What tribe do you come from?
Levite.
You're Levite? You're part of Creole, right?
I same here.
And me too, my family from Gonai. Let me ask you something. 1 Samuel 2:3.
Okay, have you ever experienced if you casting out a demon?
Of course. We cast out demons all the time, brother.
Right.
We're not brothers all the time.
Laying hands on people.
Yes, brother. We cast demons out all the time.
Exorcist.
Brother, staff. Yo, listen, brother. People foaming in South Beach, crying, trying to hold, kiss everybody. We casting out demons out of our people, brother.
You know who you stand in front of right now?
We stand in front of, brother.
A seer.
A what?
You standing in front of a seer.
A prophet?
Yes.
Let me show you something. First Chronicles 14:37. Give me that, quick. If you profess you're a prophet, you got to be doing something, brother.
Listen,
I don't think you're doing it right now, brother.
Listen,
I want to see though. Do you believe in the Bible?
Of course not.
You believe in the Bible, brother?
Because you know why?
Why?
In the beginning was the Word.
Was the Word?
In the beginning was 14. In the beginning was the Word.
Right.
And the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So what that means?
Quick.
What that means?
Let me show you something. I'm gonna answer a question.
That's the Trinity.
I'm gonna answer a question.
You believe in the Trinity?
Let me show you something.
You believe in the Trinity?
Let's answer that one question. You say you're a prophet. You're a seer. Ra'ah, you do, right? Let's find out.
This is the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 14, verse 37.
Right.
If any man.
If what?
If any man.
What?
If any man
read,
think himself to be a prophet.
To be a prophet. You said you was a prophet, right? Read.
Or spiritual, let him acknowledge.
The what?
Let him acknowledge,
right,
that the things that I write unto you,
right,
are the commandments.
Are the what?
Are the commandments.
Are the what?
Are the commandments.
If you was a prophet, brother, you would have had your beard and your fringes, and you would have been right here with us telling our people why they're in slavery, brother.
Yes, that's right. Check this out, though.
If he was a prophet, 1 Samuel 2, verse 3.
Check this out. Yeah, a lot of people see me running around the street, but guess what? I'm not smoking no damn drugs. That's what I'm doing.
What you doing?
Preaching.
Preaching what?
Preaching.
Preaching what?
The word of Yahweh.
Matthew 7, verse 1.
The word of Yahweh.
Matthew 7, verse 1. And first.
Give me a second reading.
I preached that word now. I know that word.
First Matthew 7, verse 1.
No Bible scout or none of that. I learned it from the Holy Spirit.
Matthew 7, verse 1. Read this scripture right quick. Read.
This is the book of
and
Matthew, chapter 7, verse 1,
right?
Read. Judge not,
right?
That ye be not judged.
Most like God said, you can't judge unless you're gonna be judged, unless you're gonna be condemned.
Let's find out why.
Give me the mic. I'll talk to
you. Nah, give me the mic.
We can't give out.
I'm gonna show you something.
Let the scripture come out.
You're a prophet, right? Read.
Yo, you standing in front of the gospel.
What,
right?
Judgment ye judge?
Right? You're standing in front of the gospel.
Ye shall be judged.
You should be what?
Ye shall be judged.
Because you can't tell our people to keep God's commandments. You haven't got your fringes. You don't got your beard.
Yeah, right. Why don't you want to give me the mic?
Teach our people, man.
Why don't you want to give me the mic?
And with what measure ye meet,
right?
It shall be me measured to you again.
The same thing you trying
Guess
to preach
what?
To our people. That judgment gonna fall on you, brother.
Guess what?
You gotta keep God's commandments.
Check this out, though.
What's going on?
I don't have to be around nobody to preach the word.
Why is that?
Because you know why? God is with me.
Zephaniah 2, verse 1.
This is the book of 1 Samuel, chapter 2, verse 3.
Right?
Talk no more so exceeding proudly.
You can't talk proudly, brother.
Who?
Read.
Not no.
Read again.
Verse 3. Talk no more so exceeding proudly.
Read one more time.
Talk no more so exceeding proudly.
Right?
Let not arrogancy come out of your mouth.
Don't let that come. Because we're not out here to beat you up, brother. Do not bring that. I'm going to show you something.
For the Most High is a power of knowledge.
He's the God of knowledge. Read.
And by Him, actions are weighed.
By what?
By Him, actions are weighed.
By
Him, actions are weighed.
By Him, actions are weighed, man. We got to keep God's commandments. Romans 2:13.
Hold on. Matter of fact, I don't even preach no scripture. I'm going to read something right now.
Go ahead.
This is what it says right here. It says, therefore, let anyone who thinks that he stands, Take heed lest he fall. So if y'all think y'all higher than yourself, listen, if y'all think y'all higher than yourself, y'all ain't higher than nobody. Because you know why? Yahweh's the highest. Sky's not the limit.
So that's believing that.
And then look what it say right here.
Go ahead.
I ain't finished now.
Yeah.
No temptations has overtaken that is not common to man.
Right.
To God that is faithful, and he will not let you be tempted. Right? This is what it says, right?
I'm listening.
Beyond your ability. But with the temptations, he will escape. It says he will provide escape for us. That's what it says right here.
What is it saying, brother?
So if I think I'm higher than myself, I'm not here to judge nobody. Because you know why?
Why?
I'm number water and dirt. Because when I die, I go back to the dust.
So we're not supposed to judge, brother?
No, you're not.
First Corinthians 2:15.
Where it says it at?
Let's find out.
If you judge, you will be judged yourself.
2:15. But let's find out.
What?
We gonna prove it according to the Bible.
Go to Matthew chapter 7.
Go to Matthew chapter 7. You're a hypocrite according to the Bible.
Who?
Read that.
This is the book of 1 Corinthians.
You judge yourself. Guess what?
He that is spiritual. Judges all things. Who is judging?
This is the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 1.
Read.
Dare any of you.
Stop right
read,
there.
Read.
Having matter right against stop another.
Right. That you have a matter against stop me, right, right? You say we can't judge, right?
We cannot
That's
judge.
What the Bible say.
Read. We cannot judge.
Go to law.
7, verse 9, you said.
Before the unjust.
That we do what?
Go to law before the unjust.
We gotta go to his law, statute, commandments, like I told you about your beard and your fringes, brother.
And not silence before the saints.
I got the scripture.
Let's go on, brother. We here for you, brother.
I got the scripture.
I want you to think we're trying to wild up on you.
No, I got the scripture.
Now, can we finish the scripture first?
Listen,
I let you
hold
quote.
Hold on.
I let
stop
you
right,
quote.
Stop right there.
Continue reading.
It says,
do you know that the saints, do ye know that the saints shall judge the world?
Now, who are the saints according to God, brother?
You know what he's talking about?
Now, who are the saints according to God?
We are the saints.
Who? Who's going
us,
to be?
Us.
Who's us?
Us.
Is it the bag, the pole,
I
the
ain't
garment?
None of that. Ain't who? Yeah, but listen though. I'm finna read something to you.
I thought you said we can't judge.
Hold it. I'm finna show you why I can't judge. Judge not. So you will not be judged.
Right.
What did it say right here?
Right.
What did it say?
That's Matthew 7, right?
What did it say? Of course.
Read it.
That's what it said. Who is you to judge?
We're going
to
break it down, bro.
You is not God.
We're going to break it down, brother.
You is not God. You is not God.
You got it, right?
You is not God.
We're going to go to your verse.
You is not God.
We're going to go to your verse, brother. Calm down.
No.
We're
going
to go to your verse.
No. It says.
This is the book
of judgment.
We're going to read to your verse.
This is the book of Matthew chapter 7, verse 1.
That's what you're reading, right? Correct?
Read the whole thing.
We're going to read the whole thing.
Read the whole thing.
Read.
Judge not that ye be not judged.
Let's find out why he said that. Read.
For with what judgment ye judge.
Matthew 22 verse 9. Get that quick. Hold that for me.
Read. Ye shall be judged.
He said don't judge because the same thing you coming out your mouth and saying, you're going to be judged with the same thing.
Read. And what measure ye meet, it shall be measured to you again.
Right. Read.
And why beholdest thou a mote?
What?
Why beholdest thou the mote?
Now, what is the mote? We're going to read your verse.
Yes, of course.
No, brother. We're going to deal with this verse. You pull this out, right?
Of course.
Let's deal with it. What is a mote in your eye? What is that? Like a stick, right? Like a pierre bois, right?
Of course.
Okay.
Read. And why beholdest thou the mote in thy brother's eye? In thy brother's eye.
Now, he said you got a stick in your eye, and you're worrying about the stick in your brother's eye.
Read. But not considereth the beam that is in thy own eye.
Right?
Or how wilt thou say to thy brother?
How you gonna tell your brother, Reed?
Let me pour out the mote out of thy eye.
Yo, we the Hebrews. Keep God's commandments. Reed, we're gonna deal with your verse. Remember that. We're gonna deal with your verse.
Reed. And behold, a beam is in thy own eye.
But you committing the same sin he's doing. Right. We all got beards. I can tell you supposed to have your beard.
Right.
I got my fringes. I can tell you put some fringes on, brother.
So you say Matthew 22, right?
This is the book of Matthew chapter 22, verse 9.
Right.
Go ye therefore into the highway.
Verse 29.
29.
Come on. My bad.
22. The book of Matthew chapter 22, verse 29.
Right.
And your house shall answer and say unto them,
right.
Ye do err.
Do what?
You do err.
Do what?
Ye do err.
What?
Ye do err. Not knowing the scriptures.
Because you didn't understand that verse, brother.
That's who didn't understand that verse?
That's talking about hypocrisy.
Who did not understand that verse?
Let me ask you a question. You didn't understand that verse?
Of course I understand that verse.
If you did, you want to understand, I could judge you. Zechariah 7
no,
verse
you
9.
You cannot this, judge.
Zechariah 7 verse 9.
God this is the book of Zechariah chapter 7 verse 9.
Let's see what God says.
Thus speaketh the Most High of hosts.
Right.
Saying. Execute true judgment.
What?
Execute true judgment.
What?
Execute true judgment. Execute true judgment. Execute true judgment. Execute true judgment.
Right?
Answer this question right here. If y'all was true Messianic Jews, y'all wouldn't be wearing that.
Why wouldn't he be wearing that?
You wouldn't be wearing that.
Isaiah 52 verse 1. Get that for me.
So we be wearing a Yamakula and a Tzitzit.
Come on, man. Let's find out.
I know it.
Brother,
come on, listen.
Don't get hyped and run away, brother. We pulling everything out of the Bible, man. We cutting up everything you say.
Now check this out, though. But if y'all was true Messianic,
this is the book of Isaiah, chapter 52, verse 1.
Let's find out, brother.
Read. Awake.
God said, wake up. Read.
Wake up.
Put on thy strength.
Put on thy strength.
Read.
O Zion.
We Zion.
Read. Put on thy beautiful garments.
What?
Put on thy beautiful garments. Put on thy beautiful garments. Put on thy beautiful garments.
God told us we have to wear our clothing again. That's part of our heritage. Walking around with your pants below your behind, that's not our heritage, brother.
What?
Walking around with your fringes,
I don't
that's not our, that's our, I never said
I don't
that
sag.
Thou
sag.
Sayest.
I don't sag.
Read that for me.
I got the book of Jeremiah, chapter 6, verse 16.
Right?
Thus saith the Most High.
Right?
Stand ye in the ways, and see, and ask for the old paths. And ask for the old paths.
The beards.
And ask for the old paths.
The commandments.
And ask for the old paths.
The garments.
And ask for the old paths.
The head wraps.
And ask for the old paths.
Hold on. No. Brother, don't do that and run away.
No.
You said the Old Testament. So we're not supposed to keep the commandments in the New Testament?
Look, the Old Testament is the New Testament concealed. And the New Testament is the Old Testament concealed.
Brother, we got the breakdown already, brother. Why don't you come to 2937 and find out?
You tripping.
We know that, brother. So are we not supposed to keep the commandments?
Tripping.
Are we not supposed to keep the commandments? Answer my question.
You know
are we not supposed to keep the commandments?
Of course y'all supposed to keep the commandments.
So what are you trying to say?
Shema Yisrael Adonai Eloheinu. You know what that means?
Shema Yisrael Adonai Eloheinu.
Okay.
Right.
Brother, you're not for the most part, brother. We the real men of the Most High God.
That's right.
Now, what is your point you're trying to make about the Old Testament and New Testament? What is your point
you're trying to make? Only way. You hold the old, the Ten Commandments. Shema Israel Adonai Eloheinu. You know what that means?
Yes, we understand what that means. Israel Yahweh is one.
Okay, love your neighbors as yourself.
Now, how do you show
love
your neighbor's
love? Love the Lord God with all your heart.
Leviticus 19:17, 1 John 2:11.
Come on, man. I know what I'm talking
now,
about.
Now, how do you show your neighbor you love him?
What do you mean? You by actions.
How?
By actions.
So if I go over there and give you a high five, is that showing you love, brother?
If you see a homeless person right now, I got food right here. I'm going to walk up to him and say Yahweh bless you.
What about you? What about people so-called Arab, East Indian, and Chinese? Is that showing love?
I don't care about that. The Muslims,
you don't care about that?
Listen, check this out.
The French cared about that when I was killing our people in Haiti.
That's right.
The French ain't do that to us, man. Right. You gotta wake up and keep God's commandments, right, man.
You gotta wake up.
What is how you show your neighbor love?
What do you mean?
How do you show your neighbor love?
You show him by action.
Let's find out. According to God.
You show him
the book of Leviticus chapter 19, verse 17.
Right.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart.
Right.
Thou shalt in any wise. Rebuke!
We gotta rebuke you, brother, when you're doing something wrong. That's how you show love, man.
You know,
if I see you smoking, I'm gonna say your brother,
you
man.
You know what
rebuke is? I'll feed me by ass, man. That's love. When I see you without your friends, oh, we're supposed to make the pump on the mayo. That's the law. That's how I'm showing
listen,
you love.
Check this out, bro.
What's going on, brother? We put with everything you're saying,
listen,
brother. You gotta stop resisting the spirit,
right? I'm not resisting
the spirit. You're resisting the Most High God right now. You're not fighting me and men, brother. You're fighting the Most High God at this point, man.
Listen.
You see that, brother? We put everything
for you to study.
That's the spirit,
for you to study, you gotta study the spirit.
What's the spirit?
My eyes is open all
the
time.
What's the spirit?
The Ruach HaKodesh.
What's the spirit?
The Ruach HaKodesh, Holy Spirit. What you mean? Holy Spirit.
The Kodesh Makkah.
Can I just... The Ruach HaKodesh. You know what that means? Ruach HaKodesh.
Hold on.